Hello viewers, this is Ma'am Priya Choli. Welcome to my YouTube channel Excel in Science. So today we are going to start a chapter of chemistry, that is first chapter, matter in our surroundings. You all have read about matter before also in your previous classes. You know what matter is. Matter is all around the universe, anything that we see, whether it is a pen, a body, air, water, anything that we see around us, that is matter. Matter, the definition for matter, proper definition is matter is anything that occupies space and has mass or volume, because liquid things we take our measure in volume. Like if we say this pen is occupying this much space, right? And it has some mass also, because it is made up of matter, right? Early Indian philosophers, they classified matter in the form of five basic elements. In Hindi, it is known as panch tattva. What were these panch tattva? Air, earth, fire, sky and water. That is Vayu, Prithvi, Agni, Akash or Jal. Right? So they said that these five basic elements, they form the matter. Same way the Greek philosophers also, they also agreed with the same theory. But the modern day scientists, they classified matter on the basis of their physical properties and the chemical nature. In this chapter, we are going to study only about the physical properties of matter. Chemical nature, of course, that will be taken afterwards. So, if we see the physical nature of matter, the first thing is, now some scientists, they believe that matter is continuous, just like a log of wood. Right? So they said it is continuous, but the other ones, they said no, it is particulate in nature. Particulate in nature means matter is made up of particles. It is not continuous like sand. Sand, if we see it, it is made up of very small particles. Now how did they prove it? To prove this, let us take an experiment. In this experiment, we take a beaker having, say, suppose 50 ml of water, right? Now, in this 50 ml of water, we take a spoonful of salt and put it in this water. After that, we take a glass rod and stir it very nicely. Now, we will see that still it measures 50 ml. So where has that salt disappeared? Where is that salt gone? It has actually taken the place which was in between the water particles. That means this water is not continuous. It is made up of small particles and there is some space in between. And the salt particles, they took that place, right? So this proved that matter is not continuous, it is particulate in nature or made up of particles. The second thing they said, the scientists said, that particles of matter are very small in size. Now how to prove that they are very small in size? Suppose we take a crystal of potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate, it has a pink color, right? Now what we do is, we take 100 milliliters of water in a beaker. Now in this beaker, we put just one or two crystals of potassium permanganate. It will turn dark pink in color. Now we take another beaker, in that we take 90 ml of water. We take 10 ml of water in a test tube from the first beaker and put it in this second beaker. Now what will happen? This will also turn pink in color. Now again, we repeat the same thing. We take 90 ml of water again. Now in this also, from this beaker now, that is the second beaker, we take 10 ml of water, which is already pink in color, and pour it in the third beaker. We will see this also turns pink in color. Again, the repetition will do, and we go on repeating this. Right? We will see that the water is continuously turning pink in color, although the color will not be as dark as the first one. It will go on lightly, but still turning pink in color. So what does this prove? This proves that a small crystal, we added just one or two crystals of potassium permanganate. So those one or two crystals of potassium permanganate, they had so many particles in them which were very, very small, that continuously were breaking up and the color was turning pink. You can do this exercise at home also. I know you will not have potassium permanganate with you, but you can do it with a simple Dettol. Dettol almost, you have like Dettol or anything which has got some smell, right? So if you go on doing this experiment, you will see that the smell of Dettol will persist even after 5 or 7 glasses. You don't have the beaker at home, you can do it in the glass. So if you go on doing this experiment, you will see that the smell will keep on persisting. This shows that particles of matter are very, very small in size, right? So now we come to the characteristics of particles of matter. What are the characteristics? First is, particles of matter have space between them. Like we did in this first experiment, you can perform experiment with other things also, like you prepare lemonade at home, you prepare milkshake at home, you add sugar, salt, or the other things in it, you will see that they keep on mixing in the water without the volume rising up, right? So that shows that particles of matter have space between them, and the other thing which you are mixing, that goes and occupies that space. Second is, particles of matter are continuously moving. Like for example, you take incense sticks, that is agarbatti, you place it in any corner of the room, you will not get its smell, right? Until unless you go very near it and bring it near to your nose, you smell it, you are not going to get its smell. But if you let that agarbatti in one corner of the room, you are in the other corner, still you will get that perfume of the agarbatti. Why? Because the particles of the matter, they will move along with the air and reach you. Same way, suppose your mother is cooking something in the kitchen and you come from outside, you get that flavor, that aroma. You come to know what is being cooked in the kitchen. So how do you come to know about that? That is because the particles of matter are moving along with the air, they are moving. So that is, we can say, they possess kinetic energy. Now what is kinetic energy? You have read before, there are two types of energies, potential energy and kinetic energy. Potential energy is the energy possessed by anything when it is just at one place only. It is not moving. Like if you keep a ball on the floor, that possesses potential energy. But if you kick it, it starts moving. So that moving ball has kinetic energy. So the energy possessed by any body when it is in motion, that is known as kinetic energy. So the particles of matter also possess kinetic energy because they are continuously moving. Now this kinetic energy, with increase in temperature, kinetic energy of particles also increases. How can you prove that? Like if you take some copper sulfate or potassium permanganate, anything, and you take two beakers, separate beakers of water. In one there is cold water, in the other there is hot water. Now you mix the crystals of copper sulfate in the cold water first, and then you put them in the hot water. You will see that as you put this copper sulfate in the beaker of water, these crystals, they will start dissolving. It will take some time in cold water, but if you put them in hot water, they will immediately mix with the water and the water will turn blue in color, right? So why this happens? Because as the temperature is increased, the kinetic energy of particles will also increase, the motion will increase. It will start mixing faster. Now if you take two glasses of water again, in one you put salt and just keep it without stirring, just keep it for some time. Or you don't take salt, you take ink. Right? You take blue ink or red ink, two or three drops of ink you put in water. In the other glass of water, you put some honey. Now in both the cases, you leave them as such without stirring them. So what do you think? Which one will get mixed faster? Of course, the ink. That will get mixed faster. The whole color, the color of the water will change. But honey will take some time to get mixed. So this also happens because as the density increases, the particles will take some time to mix. The less the density, it will mix faster. Now, there's a line written here, just go through it. Intermixing of particles of two different types of matter on their own is called diffusion. So this, what all we are reading just now, this whole process is known as diffusion. When two different particles, they intermix with each other. There was a scientist, Robert Brown, right? So he did an experiment. He took pollen grains and put them in water and observed it under the microscope. He saw that the particles of pollen grain, they were moving in a zigzag manner. So this zigzag portion, the zigzag motion of particles, he named them as Brownian movement, right? And this Brownian movement, this is called as diffusion. And this diffusion, it becomes faster on heating. Third is particles of matter attract each other. Now, your books also, you will see an experiment in which they have shown that the Bihu dancers, you know how the Bihu dancers, they hold themselves from the back, they just lock themselves, they lock their arms, right? So, if suppose three or four girls are standing in that position, and the other group of girls, they are just holding their hands and standing. In the third one, those three, four girls, they are just holding their hands by the tips of the fingers. Now, if you go around them and you try to separate them out, so which ones will you be, which group will you be able to separate out very easily? Of course, the third group, which were just holding their hands by the tips of their fingers. Why? Because the particles of matter, they attract each other. There is a force of attraction. Like if you take an iron nail, a chalk piece and a rubber band or any elastic, you try to hammer it you're taking iron name, you take a chalk piece and a rubber band. Now you try to hammer this iron nail or cut the chalk or just stretch the rubber band. Which one is easier to do so? That is the rubber band. And which one is difficult one? The iron nail. That means in iron nail, the particles have more force of attraction. Right? Now, suppose you try to cut the stream of water, you open the tap, water will come out, you try to cut it with your finger. Are you able to cut the water stream with your finger? No. Why? Why? Because the water particles, they have force of attraction between them. That is why you are not able to cut the stream of water. Same way, you see that a diver is able to swim. How is he able to swim? If there was a log of wood kept there, would he be able to pass through that? No. But he is able to swim. Why? Because of the space in between, there is less force of attraction. So, if we take a summary of what we have read till now, we have read that matter is particulate in nature, that is, it is made up of particles. The size of the particles is very small. Particles of matter have space between them. They are continuously moving and they attract each other. So viewers, next topic where I'll cover in the next video now. And if you have liked my video, please like, share, comment and subscribe my channel. You can, if you have any queries, you can write them in your comment section. I'll try to take them up in the next video. Thank you.